I know you have so many things to tell us, and also you have a master plan how to implement the things in our country, because you are expert in implementing ISO standard and this thing in several countries. So I would like to invite you to share your views with us.
Selamat petang. You learned that, right? good afternoon, His Excellency, the Sri Lanka High Commissioner to Malaysia, Mr. AJM Zamil, and the President of College of Health Sri Lanka, Mr. Ravi. I call him Shah Rukh Khan. And Ms. Secretary, Ms. Puspa, yeah, and Secretary of the College of Medical Lab, College of Medical Laboratory, and members in the participants from the Ministry of Health. Yeah, just let me introduce Sirin, yeah, because just sharing with you. I am from Sirin STS, Sirin Training Services, Standards and Training Services. We have a holding company called Sirin Berhad, and we have many subsidiary, and one of the subsidiary companies is a certification body certifying systems and products, but not laboratories. Laboratories are not under certification. It is under accreditation, and the accreditation body in Malaysia is Standards Malaysia, and Department of Standards Malaysia. And it is an agency under the Science, Ministry of Science. Okay? Right. We have spent 9 days, yeah? Our contact days, myself and the participants, have been actually 8 days, yeah? One day you had a technical visit. And we have covered the introduction to ISO 15189. And I insist that they read the standard. Yeah, you all read the standard, right? Technical training on the measurement uncertainty. Like I told you, in life, only three things are certain. What is that? The rest is uncertain. You remember? Dying is certain, getting old is certain, and tax is certain. The rest is uncertain. So is the measurement in your lab. And now the last 2 days, yeah, yesterday and today, we did it. Internal audit. Okay, internal audit is very, very important. And the quality manager, the quality manager has a role in this implementation, because he or she is going to be the one who is going to establish the system. Establish and monitor and maintaining the system. So it's good to, have a quality manager to be appointed soon. Complying, what does it mean to comply to ISO 15189? What does it mean to be accredited? It means that you are competent. This means that this lab is competent, and this lab is practicing quality management system. And remember I told you, what is quality? Quality is fulfilling customer requirements. And why do we want to tell people that we are competent? So that the results is valid. Okay, so it is important for a lab to be accredited. You can practice ISO 15189, but if you are not accredited, it is has no weight. Yeah, because accreditation gives you a stamp, yeah, that the whole world recognize this laboratory, and the people in the laboratory is competent. Okay, so now that you have attended these courses, four courses, it is actually sufficient for you now to go home and develop the system and practice the system, right? So what I can say is, the next step after this is for you to, because I was made to understand, in Sri Lanka you do not have an accreditation framework. You have to develop the accreditation framework first then only you can seek accreditation to your lab. Alright, and Malaysia, you're welcome to talk with our standards, Malaysia department, on how to guide you to come up with the accreditation framework. Alright, and then I want to make comments. The 31 people that attended the class, they are very, very committed. Sometimes it scares me because they are so committed. They are so dedicated, and I have a lot of questions from the intelligent group. So please remember what I told you. If you don't practice what you learn in 21 days, you will forget it. Okay, when you go home, start developing your system and do your measurement uncertainty.